What's up, everyone? And happy Halloween, everybody. It's me, Zian Skaima, and welcome to Fantasy Cross Duels of Nightmare Halls for Super Power Beatdown. And today's creepers I got here are Chef the Killer versus the Bloody Painter. I'm giving you guys a creepypasta beatdown battle. And this is the last episode of Nightmare Halls for Super Power Beatdown of the year. So thank you for watching all the videos of Nightmare Halls for Super Power Beatdown. And tomorrow I will do the special one, and that is Spawn versus Dante from Devil May Cry. If you don't want to miss it, subscribe right now. And let me know in the comments who will win out of this nightmare battle. As for me, I'm gonna go for Jeff the Killer. Yeah, he's the most terrifying and more powerful than the Bloody Painter. I discovered the Bloody Painter one of the videos of I'm Jay Station. That guy was doing some type of summoning, and that video did scare me the first time I saw it. But I can't find that video anymore because that guy's channel got terminated. But I won't be talking about that right now. Maybe I will talk about that some other day, because right now I'm doing the last episode of Nightmare Halls for Super Power Beatdown. And Jeff the Killer, he's my favorite creepypasta character. Alright, so enough chatting, let us begin. And before I start this video, if you don't like it, just click the dislike button and there's gonna be not a single problem. Okay, so we all set, let us begin. Jeff the Killer versus the Bloody Painter. Jeff the Killer versus the Bloody Painter. Let the nightmare begin. I'm going to check out the news later on and see if there's going to be some trick-or-treating for tomorrow or not, because I really want to go outside, get some treats around in people's houses with all their decoration. Oh, I think I'm gonna do my live stream tomorrow around the afternoon, because I was busy making these videos, but right now I'm done, and later on I'll be doing the last ones, and those are the special ones. Right now I just finished all my videos of 1 Minute Melee, and this is the last one for Super Power Beatdown. Alright, the Bloody Painter won this round. The first point goes to him. There's a lot of bunch of cool creepypasta characters I just discovered. I went to the top list, like, to see if there's any good ones, and there are. Some of them, they're not that great. Jeff the Killer and the Bloody Painter are the greatest creepypasta characters. Ring out. Now we got a tie. Both creepers got 1 point each. They should do a fighting game with the creepypasta characters, don't you think? Because they've done a game with all the terrified characters from scary movies. Why not creepypasta? If they do, I think I'll be playing Jeff the Killer the most. 2016. I dressed myself as Jeff the Killer, but I didn't have any makeup and I forgot to buy my little plastic knife. But I only took my black pants and a white hoodie. Alright, another point for Jeff the Killer and clothes ripped out from Bloody Painter. Well, not really a white hoodie, a gray one, but nobody noticed it. And I told everybody I'm dressed as Jeff the Killer. But around 2016, that's when I discovered some of the creepypasta characters like Laughing Jack, Tiki Toby, The Rake, Smiling Dog, and Ring Out. Now we got a tie again. Both creepers got 2 points each. And before I was doing the videos, I was hearing their origins, and some of their origins are kind of messed up, but their stories are very great. The knife is not an accessory. It's that you had to make it, and it's kind of hard to make a little knife right there. Another Ring Out, and another point for Jeff the Killer. And that little blade is a horn, and I used those horns to make my Wolverine's claws, putting like one horn at a time. I want to know which is your favorite creepypasta character. If you guys gonna go trick or treat tomorrow, let me know and what you gonna dress as. Me, I already told you, I'm gonna dress myself as Captain America because a lot of little kids, they really love my costume. And because of that, they got me a lot of joy, and I would give them more joy and more happiness as longer as I'm not dressing nothing scary. Now we got a tie. Both creepers got 3 points each, and close rip out from Jeff the Killer. If they say there's not gonna be any trick or treat tomorrow, I can do another scavenger hunt just like last year I did with my cousin, and that was kind of fun. And I had my shield, my hammer, my mask of Captain America, and I really enjoyed the end games of the Avengers. That was a tight movie. How many Ring Outs are we having on this video? And I see that Jeff the Killer got another point. I lost count. Man, there being a lot of Ring Outs right now. And that scavenger hunt was fun. My little cousin and I, we were enjoying it, and she beat me. She got more bags than me. So yeah, if there's no trick or treat, I could do another scavenger hunt for you guys. And I'm gonna invite my cousin Edu and my little cousin Anthony. Yeah guys, if there's gonna be no trick or treat tomorrow, then do a scavenger hunt because that's gonna be fun. You guys gonna like it. Alright, now we gotta tie again, and which creepypasta character is gonna take the last point? Ladies and gentlemen, today's nightmare winner is Jeff the Killer. And there he is. So what do you think about this matchup? And who you think will win? Who you gonna go for? Jeff the Killer or the Bloody Painter? You decide. Alright guys, thank you for watching the last episode of Nightmare Hollows for Superpower Beatdown. If you guys got a Nightmare Hollow, leave it in the comments, and I can do it for next year, 2022. Alright guys, so thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like. If you want to share it, go ahead, be my guest. Comment, but remember, do not leave any offensive comments or saying bad words. If you do that, your comment will be removed from this video. And subscribe to the channel for more Fantasy Cross Duels. And please follow my Facebook page, Fantasy Cross Duels. And have a happy Halloween, everybody. This is Ian Skaima, and he's out in line.